There's a ghost town at Cloudbase, way up in the sky. The streets run forever, 10,000 feet high. It's a place where old dust devils go when they die, to rest at the end of the day. To rest at the end of the day. One day on a flight west of old San Antonio, I was low in South Texas and a long way from home. I was telling my crew they should stand by the phones when a voice on my radio said, "Is that you, 4-6? I clicked my mic twice. He said, "Long time no see. Your new ship sure looks nice. I've got 10 knots behind you, and if you're rolling the dice, turn around and join me for the ride. Turn around and join me for the ride." It's against all the rules, but when I turned around, I saw this big dust devil rise from the ground. I sang that old hymn, "Once was lost, now I'm found," as it lifted my burdens away. Now if you don't believe me, I'll understand why. 'Cause when I reach cloud base 10,000 feet high, old X-ray Tango came in alongside, rocked his wings, waved his hand, and flew on. Rocked his wings, waved his hand, and flew on. We dove through the shadows, we sped towards the sun. I got him in the climb, he got me on the run. When I heard him exclaim, "Now we're having fun," I turned around and his glider was gone. I've lost friends on the highway, lost friends to the sea. Like this ghost in the sky, they are all part of me. And if life is a task toward the same mystery, we may all meet again later on. We may all meet again later on. In a place they call Cloudbase, way up in the sky, the streets run forever, 10,000 feet high. It's a place where old dust devils go when they die, to rest at the end of the day. We'll rest at the end of the day. End of the day.
And the farther you reach,
that you need.
Bless that you need.
The higher you climb. It's a mighty big sky, so I need to ask why you're closing our glider port down. You say you need the airspace to service your airbase. You don't want the traffic around, but it seems very clear you don't want a frontier where outlaws like me tend to roam. Where will anyone cry when the last glider flies and the last sailplane pilot goes home? When the FAA puts a TCA over every place that we saw and keep out signs all are posted on our ceilings and our floors. When the privilege to fly the rich comes from Washington, D.C., I will raise my cup to the last one up in a sky that once was free. I will raise my cup to the last one up in a sky that once was free. We purchased some land, assured by a man that no one would find us out here. I remember the Monday we cut the runway, watched by a hawk and two deer. Well, the very next week we got a call from a sheik, said he once owned the land next to ours, but he'd sold to GM, and next month they move in. Would we mind if they built a few cars? Now there's a giant mall, and the traffic crawls where our planes were once tied down. And late last year, a man shot two deer that had wandered into town. And there's a hawk that cries in the smoke-filled skies where she circles all alone. So I raise my cup, she's the last one up in a sky we once called home. I will raise my cup, she's the last one up in a sky we both called home. When the FAA puts a TCA over every place that we saw, and keep out signs all are posted on our ceilings and our floors, when the privilege to fly the ridge comes from Washington, D.C., I will raise my cup to the last one up in a sky that once was free. I will raise my cup to the last one up in a sky that once was free. Ridgerunners, ridgerunners down on the trees, four fully loaded gliders in a 20-knot breeze. Belts across your bodies, maps across your knees, Pennsylvania through Virginia, turn around in Tennessee. Will you make it back home, ridgerunner? Will you make it back home, ridgerunner? Ridgerunner, ridgerunner, look up ahead. A gap across the mountains and the sky looks very dead. Get up off the deck and go for altitude instead. 3 miles can use 2,000 feet, that's what the handbook says. And you'll make it back home, ridgerunner. You'll make it back home, ridgerunner. Ridgerunners getting lower in the sky. Turn points in your cameras, but no one's very high. Radios are silent, you ain't got long to fly. Halfway down the mountain, about to kiss it all goodbye. You won't make it back home, Ridgerunner. You won't make it back home. Ridgerunners, ridgerunners up in the way. Jesus must be wondering just how you boys got saved. Almost 6 feet under, now you're dancing on your grave. Ain't nothing like some altitude to make a man feel brave. Now you'll make it back home, ridgerunner. You'll make it back home. One more ridge to run, the home field comes in sight. Red line information now to end this record flight. Then put the planes away so you can stay up half the night and say, can you believe that clouds be boys, we must be living right. Cause we made it back home, Ridge Runner. Yes, we made it back home, Ridge Runner. We made it back home, 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 Ridgerunner. Yes, we made it back home, Ridgerunner. My doctor called me on the phone and said the tests are in. It's worse than we expected. This looks kind of grim, but don't lose hope, cause in the past Johnson has been wrong. Meet me at the airport, bring your plane along. Take a glider, take a tow, call me in the morning. Leave your message at the tone, the doctor has gone soaring. If this is an emergency, you're standing at death's door. You better call a doctor that doesn't like to soar. Had gone critical, the cues had popped to 10. You had the patient on the table and the doctor wasn't in. The assistants and the nurses were nervous as can be. They were following instructions on 1, 2, 3.3. Oh, take a glider, take a tow, call me in the morning. Leave your message at the tone, the doctor has gone soaring. If this is an emergency, you're standing at death's door. You better call a doctor that doesn't like to soar. Met him at the airport, he had the tests in hand. He had Dick Johnson's latest polars for our brand new LS-10s. We must operate, he told me, to catch this thing in time. So let's put these things together, boys, and get them on the line. Oh, take a glider, take a tow, call me in the morning. Leave your message at the tone, the doctor has gone soaring. If this is an emergency, you're standing at death's door. You better call a doctor that doesn't like to soar. At the tone, the doctor has gone soaring. If this is an emergency and you're about to die, you better call a doctor that doesn't like to fly. While reading my copy of the latest sailplane racing news, the classifieds had a most curious ad for a glider brand new, never used. I read with suspicious amusement what seemed like a wild stroke of luck. LS4A, it said, must sell, the ad read, total package $65. Well, I was used to this newsletter's typos, but I called up that number straightway. What response have you had to your classified ad? She said, none, you're my first call today. I said, there's been a mistake in my copy, and they've printed your price wrong somehow. No, no, replied she, they checked that with me. I said, don't sell that plane, I'm leaving now. She lived in a part of the city that folks like me only pass through. Airline captains, bank presidents, and doctors are the residents, and the houses are massive and new. As I turned up her half-mile-long driveway, there in the heat of the day, in the bright sunlight gleam, the plane of my dreams, just $65 away. The cockpit was lined in white sheepskin, The instruments carefully placed. A computer you read on a tiny TV, and the 10-function program worked great. A small fridge in the front of the trailer dispensed either water or wine, draft beer or iced tea. But what was boggling to me was for $65 it was mine. Well, I thought that the woman must be crazy to be selling this plane at that price. But as she walked down the lane, she seemed perfectly sane. She was charming and really quite nice. She smiled with complete satisfaction as she handed me the title and the keys. I said, I've just got to know why you've let this thing go. What's wrong with the plane? Tell me, please. She said, I'll be 50 next Tuesday. I've lived here with my husband, Earl. After 30 years wed, without a word said, he left me for a young teenage girl. But with his credit cards here on the table, I knew she'd be hard to maintain. Last month from Florida, he sent a wire to me. Said, I need money, dear, sell the plane. Okay, we're having fun now. He finally got close enough to need just one more climb. If he could top 6,000 feet, he'd be on final glide. Thermal was a weak one, a half a knot at best. But the day had died and there was nothing left. There was nothing left. At 40 miles, 6,000 feet, it's 35 to 1. And with a little luck, it can easily be done. But instead of luck, a headwind told him he'd need 42. And 40's all the factory said she'd do. One more climb, yeah. Give me one more climb that'll lift me high, yeah. Circles in the sky. Lord, please let me have just a one more climb. At 5,700 feet, it was zero all around. He tried two more circles, and he started losing ground. It was less than what he needed, but he turned and headed home. He looked for signs of lift, but there were none. There were none. The audio was quiet, the air was smooth as glass. He'd recompute the numbers with each checkpoint that he passed. At the river 22 miles out, he was still 500 low. The time had come to call and let her know. One more climb, yeah. Give me one more climb that'll lift me high, yeah. Circles in the sky. Lord, please let me have just one more climb. That morning she had kissed him just before he took his toll. She said, I want you to remember now, whenever you get low, I'll be wishing you a thermal each time you need a lift. So when all hope is gone, please don't forget. Please don't forget. No, he had not forgotten, but her idea made him laugh. Her love was always with him, and he believed in that. wishes will not get you home when what you need is height. Then something nudged his wing and said, turn right. One more climb, yeah. Give me one more climb that'll lift me high, yeah. Circles in the sky. Lord, please let me have just one more climb. He can't swear that he heard her voice, but he knows that the bump was real. And as he rolled the glider around, he got that solid feel. 2 knots to 3,000 feet, with just 10 miles to go. He called her up and he said, I'm coming home, I'm a coming home. He was one of two to finish on the task they called that day. He couldn't wait to thank her, he knew she'd be amazed. When he told her how her thermal had saved him from defeat, he found her in the trailer fast asleep. He gently shook her shoulder and she smiled a sleepy smile. He said, wake up dear, I made it, have you been asleep a while? She said, only for an hour, but I've had the strangest dream. Do you have any idea what this means? What this means. I dreamt I found a tiny bird dragging its left wing. I lifted up its feathers and the bird began to sing. It sang a tune I'd heard you singing earlier today. And then to my surprise it flew away. Said the dream is strange, all right, it's as strange can be. And when he told her of his flight, she certainly agreed. She said it proves when someone loves you, no matter what you do. From time to time you'll have a dream come true. One more climb, yeah. Give me one more climb that'll lift me high. Yeah, circles in the sky. Lord, please let me have just one more climb. Yeah, give me one more climb that'll lift me high. Yeah, circles in the sky. Lord, just let me have. Please just let me have. Please, please let me have just one more climb. Yeah. Give me one more climb that'll lift me high, yeah. Give me one more climb, give me one more climb, yeah. Give me one more climb that'll lift me high, yeah. Give me one more climb, give me one more climb, yeah. Give me one more climb that'll lift me high, yeah. Have you heard the latest news that the LS-22s will have nothing on their panel but a screen that will give the latest views from the satellite you choose and display the sink in red, the lift in green? There's no stick upon the floor, no rudders anymore. Just two wires that you plug into your brain. A computer reads your mind through a fiber optic line, and with this information flies the plane. Honey, I need a new glider. The one that we have's obsolete. Soaring's no fun at just 60 to 1. I can't expect to compete with a plane like this new 22, dear. The first first ones will be here in May. I just knew you'd decide, it's a matter of pride, so I ordered us one yesterday. The Deutschmark's headed down, and the dollar's gaining ground. It might get back to 1-to-1 again. So for just 200 grand, you place an order with a man who promises delivery by spring. Then 3 years from that date, he says just one more wait. The factory is quite busy now, you see. I know they're anxious to get through with your new LS22, 'cause they've just announced the LS23. Honey, I need a new glider. The one that we have's obsolete. Our investment is doomed if we don't trade it soon. Hell, we've had it for over a week. Just look at this new 23, dear. The first ones will be here in May. I just knew you'd decide, it's a matter of pride, so I ordered us one yesterday. For a weekend last fall, just to try and recall the whole year, all of the places and all of the races. I wonder where they all disappeared. I didn't ponder the question too long. I was hungry and went out for a bite. Ran into a chum who owned an old LS1, and we wound up talking all night about those changes in attitudes, changes in altitudes. Nothing remains quite the same. With all of our climbing and all of our running, if we couldn't soar, we would all go insane. Making a turn point at some little airport reminds me of the places I've been. Memories of great flights that brought so much pleasure make me want to go back again. If my life suddenly ended tomorrow, I could somehow adjust to my fate. All I would need is the call to proceed as I'm diving through St. Peter's Gate. It's those changes in attitudes, changes in altitudes. Nothing remains quite the same. With all of the high flights and all of the relights, if we couldn't soar, we would all go insane. Sometimes when I'm working, I look at the sky, and part of my heart takes a toll. I connect with a cloud street somewhere in West Texas. Oh God, how I'm ready to go. Then somebody taps on my shoulder, and I quickly get out of my plane. When they see the grin and they ask where I've been, I don't even try to explain about those changes in attitudes, changes in altitudes. Nothing remains quite the same. All of our climbing